Hey everybody, it's Emily at ARC Schooling, and today I'm going to be filming my 2018 reading goals wrap-up. I set the bar pretty low for 2018, knowing that it was going to be a crazy year and that I wasn't going to be able to do a crazy amount of stuff. And I'm very pleased that I did that because I feel accomplished now that I actually met all of my goals just about. There's only one thing I didn't quite manage, but that's okay. The first goal was that I set my Goodreads to 70. I wanted to hit 70 books. And I figured that was a pretty doable goal for me. I read fairly fast, I read a lot, so I thought I'd surely be able to hit 70 books. And not only did I hit 70 books, I went over 100. So currently, there's still 2 weeks left of this year, and I'm probably going to finish at least two more books, potentially three. So I'm currently at 101. I'm going to probably hit somewhere in the 103, 104. Which is ridiculous because since I've been tracking, I've always read a lot, but since I've actually kept track of the books I've read on Goodreads, I've never done more than like 85 books. So this is the highest I've ever done, which is super exciting for me. As crazy as a year as I've had, I feel like that was really accomplished. So then I also was doing the Pop Sugar Reading Challenge, and well, I didn't 100% finish it. I did really well with it. I hit almost all the challenges. The only ones I didn't do, and I didn't do the advanced at all. I didn't even bother to try with the advanced challenges, so just the regular ones. The only ones that I didn't do, I didn't read a book made into a movie I've already seen because I just, like, I couldn't figure out what I'd want to read, and I just could not come up with a book to fit that one. And then I didn't do true crime. Even though I had a book planned for that, I was going to read Devil in the White City or I'll Be Gone in the Dark. I had two choices, and yet I still, for whatever reason, didn't pick those up. What are you going to do? I didn't read a Nordic noir because what even is that? I strongly dislike when a reading challenge throws in just like the super random, specific category, and like, I don't read that. I don't do noir ever, and I don't know why I'd pick up Nordic noir. So I didn't do that challenge. I did not read a book with a female author using a male pseudonym. Again, I had a book planned, and I didn't get there. I was gonna read, I think Cuckoo's Calling is the first one that J.K. Rowling did in that series under the pen name Robert Galbraith. I was gonna do that. Didn't get to it. I did not read a book that was also a stage play. Again, I had a book in mind. I just haven't gotten to it yet, and I know I'm not going to get there yet this year, so it's not going to happen. I was going to read Dear Evan Hansen. I did not read a book about a sport, and I knew going in that wasn't going to happen. Like, I'd already crossed that one off my list because I don't do sports, and I just don't want to read about it. Did not read a book mentioned in another book because I just couldn't quite figure out what I wanted to read for that. And I didn't read a book with an ugly cover because I don't have a book that I would consider having an ugly cover. And I didn't want to go find one. So other than those things, I actually checked off like almost every box. So I was pretty psyched about that. So that was great. Also, I filmed a video at the beginning of the year with the 10 books I wanted to read in 2018. And of those 10, I read two. So, and I loved both of the books I read. They were both 5 stars. So that was cool. So I did read Long Way to a Small Angry Planet, and I did read My Best Friend's Exorcism. I'm going to link that video. I don't know if it's on this side or this side. I'm going to link it up here somewhere so you can go back and see that video. And yeah, so I think I did pretty well. I'm pretty psyched with what I accomplished reading-wise in 2018. Because, like I said, this was just a hectic year. I had a lot on my plate between work on Level 11 for Build Your Library and being sick at the beginning of the year and having to deal with that throughout the year because that sick was the worst at the beginning of the year, but it didn't get better. I didn't, like, 100% recover, and it's been an interesting ride. I might do a video about that. I don't know. I might film a video about my year with ulcerative colitis. I don't know if anyone would want to watch that, but it's something that I've dealt with a lot this year, so maybe. But aside from all of that, reading over 100 books was just like, I've done all the things now. I can die happy. So, what did you accomplish in 2018? Did you hit your goals? I hope you did. I hope everyone was able to have a great reading year in 2018, and I hope you all have a great reading year in 2019. I'm going to be filming my top 10 video next, so that'll be going up really soon after you see this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Happy reading. Bye!